My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to Enter the Gungeon, the supply drop update, the beta thereof. Now, this is the first time since the holidays, most recent, that I've actually played the video game, so what I'm gonna do is give myself a special little gift of being able to play my two favorite characters next, because I can't remember what characters I'm supposed to have at this point. Maybe Ugly's Old Hell, let me drink in peace. Wait a second, I was about to say, there was a comment that asked me to talk to the Trork Man. But I think it was saying that if you talk to Trork in-game, you should get one free usage of the cigarettes as he shares a cigarette with you, because he's always smoking in his shop. Which I agree with. I'm sorry, I've misconstrued it accidentally in the start of the episode. Good way to start, as always. Try and preserve as many of these shots as I can. I've wasted one shot so far. I could have used a rusty sight. Never mind. We are okay then. So, for the very start of this room, I couldn't really safely loop around both of them because they weren't close enough together. So that's why I was using the crossbow to actually take them out with relative haste. Whereas as soon as I only have one of them, they're like, you can actually just walk around them, it's fine. That's the hunt complete. Beautiful. I saw 2GG, we checked that just before we walked in, so I knew that was gonna be the case. Wait, what? Did I not hit you twice? Okay, maybe I missed. Wow, the inaccuracy is insane! Stop it! Video game, please! No, stay away. It's in fact faster to swap from the crossbow to the rusty sidearm for the second shot. Alright, what have we got in the shop? Ooh, bait launcher. Only 45 here on the first new item. 65, that means it's green tier. None of these walls are tinted yet. I should be checking for the tinted walls. I'm not really on that level yet. But the only way I'm gonna get on that level is if I continually remind myself, hey, yo, any of these walls tinted? Y slash N. I can take that now. Thank you very much. I definitely want the bait launcher, because the bait launcher for the first four floors is gonna be a completely fine room clear. So, room clear, sorry, boss clear. Oh. Hello, Black Chest. There's no arfing, so I don't even need to bother shooting it. Arfing being the dog would go arf, 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 if the chest were a mimic. Had to imagine this would be here. Shit, yo. Black chest on the first floor plus bait launcher in the shop. As long as I can get bait launcher before the boss, I'm gonna be happy. Wait, is that true? Should I force the weapon off the boss regardless? Even if I know I can get bait launcher. I can probably still force the weapon from the boss regardless, just as a result of having this gun. Crossbow is dang good. Whoa, that was bad. Okay, I think it's just you and I. Quem and I. Let's go, buddy. We'll also check the south side for tinted walls. Beautiful. Blue. Lowest tier item that I can see on this entire floor is blue. That's a good start. That said, I still haven't seen where my secret room is, so I should probably... Wait a second, no, I do that after the boss, of course. Belt of girls. Wait a second. There's another room I haven't even explored. And it's an end room, so it easily could be shop, shrine, challenge, mark room, or something like that. Oh, never mind, it's none of the above. Ah, no. None of your shenanigans, friend. Oh, secret? Yeah, secret room. Found it. And it's easily teleportable, too. Able to be teleported towards? I don't know how I should be phrasing that. Oh, whoops! Actually managed to miss so bad that we've got the other fellow in the background. Very rare that happens. Now, not certain how much I want to say, but I've not played any Gungeon for the last 4 or 5 days, perhaps? And for the last 3 days, I've done literally nothing but drink, so I'm not so certain I'll be able to get every single shot that I usually would. We're definitely gonna be trying our best. Ah! I wanted to save this blank because of the secret room. And it ended up costing me a full heart. I should have just blanked. That's really good though. I'll be taking the beehive as a good boss weapon. I'm gonna hit the blank. Boom. Eh, definitely not worth it. I traded HP up for a piece of armor. Ugh. I didn't use a blank and all I got was this lousy t-shirt. Oh, what up, Gungeon? Do I even want the passive from the blue? I kind of do. Kind of do, to be entirely honest with you. Oh, wait a second, yo. Full metal jacket. Yeah. Automated defenses. New item. What do we got? Automatically triggers available ranks when in danger. An original Gungeon item, this protective garment, laser cut hole from a massive blank, can detect when its bearer is threatened. Because I'm not going to purchase the key on this floor, I'm also not going to open this. Alright, let's get out of here. I don't know what I think about that item. It depends. What does in danger mean? What constitutes danger? Is danger if a bullet's really near me? Or is danger when a bullet hits me? If it's when a bullet is really near me, this item is fucking trash. If it's when a bullet hits me, this item is probably good? We'll just try not to get hit, and then if anything gets really close, we'll be able to see. Whoa. Almost missed out on that. I'm never going to get close enough to really loop the loop around this guy, so we'll do the long-range strats. Ooh, a solid 10 from him on this floor? Don't mind if I do. Hey, club! That is differently colored, so I do know that's my secret room. Usually secret rooms on the south side of a shop are actually quite nice, to be entirely honest with you. They typically tend to be chests. But I also don't want to use my blanks, because I want to see how the automated blank defense works. Alright, we'll hold off. God damn it. Can I please get one accuracy up? Just one. Run away. No! Okay, that's either impossibly close, or it does trigger when you get hit. Maybe it's so close as to be indistinguishable, one from the other there. Now I don't know how I feel about it for a different reason. Sure, this means that, especially in boss fights, I can just avoid getting hit. Great, that's awesome. But now I don't have any blanks left, and I'm not even at the boss yet. I think if you get a bunch of amulets, so you have a stupid amount of blanks, and you always end up with surplus blanks at the end of the floor, then this is amazing. Right, surely in that circumstance, this is pretty much 3 or 4 pieces of armor a floor. So it's like gun knight equipment, but better. I don't know. I think what's definitely going to happen is before I get to the boss, I'm going to purchase any blanks in the store. Which is something that I previously wouldn't do. Ugh. I don't know how I feel about this. I'm all topsy-turvy on my opinions here. Oh, no. Yeah. I think it does wait until you are actually hit, and then it just erases the damage. God damn it. There we go. Always try and save some bullets using those friends. Okay, you stay away from me. If we didn't get the gold casing last floor, I probably wouldn't have this item. Probably be better off if you're telling us. Not gonna buy the other one. For this boss, I think I can get away with just using bait launcher. Because Beehive is actually way better. So, of course, I'm going to want to preserve the ammo in it for later floors, if at all possible. If she'd done the sideways Uzi shot, she would have got me there. Okay, and beautiful. I was about to say final shot. I assumed the following one would be, but I forgot the delayed damage. Oh, that weapon. I don't even like that weapon. How much have I got left in the... I'll refill the bait launcher. Because I'm only going to be using the crossbow for the majority of the first floor. Next floor? For the majority of the start of the next floor? I'm not phrasing this correctly, and I'm never going to, so I give up. Now I blank this. Oh, it's only a... Wow. That's not exactly what I was looking for there. What clob cost me? 42, of course. Brown tier. Although it's more rare than any other thing in the brown... Actually, pea shoot is more rare, so... Well done, Ryan. Whoa, gun launcher? Gun launcher. That's gonna be shrine... No gun launcher. We use the Gungeon next floor. Especially because next floor we start to run into a lot of... flames. And while you have the Gungeon, you are impervious to those. It's good fun, at the very least, for that reason. One, two, three, four. Unfortunately, the quick swap over to the rusty pistol does no longer finish them off. Alright, well, we're going to be shooting this one. Just because it's brown tier. Next time, use a key. Yeah, that's fair enough. We'll open the blue. Yeah, I have no problem with that. If it's a weapon, I'm looking for Anvilin or Shade's Revolver. I'd quite like. That's quite poor. I wonder if maybe I chuck the crossbow... No. I was thinking maybe chuck both of the crossbows into the gun launcher, but the more and more I think about that, the more and more I realize that these are still not... near the worst that can come out of the two tiers that they're from. Oh, wait! Yeah, the first one hit my blank. The second one, I'm just bad. I'm gonna go roll the bones, fuck it. I actually want the normal crossbow more than the triple crossbow, so I'll use the triple crossbow. Robbed slash cleansed. Okay, all of my curse was taken away, but all of my money was taken... Well, some of my money was taken away. I believe it's between, like, 1 and 100 credits can be taken away from you and robbed. Okay. Look, it's all okay. By the way, that red button next to the door... That is for saving and quitting in the middle of a run. I've had so many people ask about it recently. It is for the ability to save and quit in the middle of a run. There you go. I'm just gonna destroy you like that. I'm gonna wear out the rest of the ammunition in this weapon, and then we'll change. Probably to bullet, because it's literally the only other room clear weapon I have. That doesn't make it good at what it does, but it does do that. Okay. Beautiful. Hey, can't believe I actually landed that one. I mean, obviously, I only want Mattman. Hey, oh, what up, Mattman? I only want Mattman because Batchison Mendy is so specific as to the runs that it's actually effective in. Just check inside of the wall. Never mind me. Yeah. Wait a second. I'm trying to feel the beat, or the rhythm, rather, of their shots. No, the beat. It's definitely the beat of their rhythm. Just so that I can predict when the next shot from each of these is coming out, and dance around them thusly. Oh, that actually was really cool and unintentional. I ended up getting the Blobulons to poison all my enemies. Oh, wait, of course, this is the weapon I'm using. Hello, friend. And again. Yeah, you don't leave fire under you. Shoot the lantern in order to get oil on the floor, and then I reload in the oil in order to not use any ammunition in the Gungeon. That is one of the special effects of the Gungeon. If you reload while you're standing in poison, goop, fire, water, whatever, it'll reload using that instead. You also have a speed up while you're holding it out, and you're immune to fire. You can see it even removes a pool of it from the floor. I didn't like pop gun. What tier is it though? Green. No, blue. That's blue. Because 65 was last floor for green. 65 was on the first floor for green. Wait, is balloon gun brown? 42, clob, last floor. No, it's gotta be blue. Okay. It's on this floor on the forge and in hell. There's so many sources of flame and oil around that you can always just reload the Gungeon for free. Occasionally, it's from enemies, like this one. Occasionally, it's just from wall breakables and area breakables and, like, braziers and pots and pans and all that good stuff. Alright. Beautiful. Back up to my 800. Yeah, I'm obviously not going to be opening that. Okay, and again. Up, 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 up. Got him. We'll break one of these, get back the ammunition. I don't know if I want to use this. Depends on the boss, I think. Yeah, no, I'll use this. Damn it. Oh, wait, that was my blank. Got it. Good. I want to use this weapon, by the way, just because I now have a speed up while I'm holding it out. And that's going to be a very important factor in preventing me from taking damage to this guy. There goes my second blank. on, and that'll do it. I have to imagine this does not count as me having been hit. No, it doesn't. Excellent. Because if that did count as me being having been hit, then this is actually a really shit weapon. I'll come back for that in a second. I need to go reload this. Beautiful. So missing 300 ammunition. That's more than completely fine. I'll be okay. I've got to remember there is a map man on this floor that I can go back to at any point. Nope. 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 Anyone else? Just bully all of them. No. Got him. Reload there. Woo! That was bad. That was worse. Reload here and... Wait, crud. Right. We've got to go find the secret room. Although I can't open it, of course. This is what I was trying to complain about. I have no blanks. Although, I do have to admit, this does make Bullet Dude's shop a lot better. Because now, any of the amulets that give you an extra blank per floor are awesome. I want as many blanks per floor as I can get. I want the white Guan Stone, kindles blanks. I want the copper chaos amulet, frost amulet, uranium amulet. I'm only naming the ones that actually give you an extra blank, because some of them don't. Despite being amulets. You'd think they'd be consistent across, but no. What's an example? The lodestone amulet doesn't give an effect to your blanks, other than increasing their knockback. So that's the easiest way to think about it. If it does like a status effect, it probably gives you an extra blank per floor. Yeah, I can open that. It's coolness up, but I actually don't like the effect of the sunglasses rather. Slows time when explosions occur. Yeah. Cool guys don't look at explosions, all that. Yeah, there you go. Unfortunately, this fight took a while, and I ended up wasting 100 ammunition in it. But that still makes this way more ammo effective than most other weapons in the game. Alright, that's really important. That might be. Oh, actually, no, I'll take bracket key. Hello, secret room. I kind of just bought armor, but whatever. What have you got? Easy reload bullets is really bad. Guess I'm now purchasing a key. So I took the bracket key just so that I have the easy destruction of rooms. Anything's pissing me off, I just hit the bracket key button. It's also one level of curse. Whether or not that makes a difference to me. It doesn't, but it could, I guess. Theoretically. Alright, let's get out of here.
What is this?
Stop freezing time. I don't care. Thankfully, anywhere there's Blobulons and especially Ice Thwomps, I'm going to be able to reload easily multiple times in a room and keep all of my ammunition. This is especially important here because there's no wall lanterns or anything like that. So I actually do have to rely on reloading like this. Pretty certain I'm screwed in a second, though. Never mind. Found somewhere to reload. Woo! Get away. And you two. And you final. And that'll do it, I'm pretty certain. Wow! Actually managed to get that done effectively. I did not think that was gonna work. All of these rolls have been shit, though. That spent a blank? That was melee, though. I assumed it would only do it on bullets. Ooh, yeah, I'm gonna be entirely out of blanks by the time we get to the boss. This is gonna really harm my ability to get master rounds. I'm not gonna drop the item because it's the first time I've ever interacted with it. But I'm probably not going to pick this item up again unless I already have a way to get easy blanks. Damn it. Yeah. I wonder if the appearance of these key blanks has anything to do with your coolness. Because your coolness affects your luck stat. And it's quite lucky to have those, right? It's entirely possible. It's just something we don't know yet. Alright. No, 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 no. You know what? If I just kill this guy, we're fine. Because the king will stop summoning. As soon as the only enemy in the room is the king. I'm fine with now just constantly reloading this gun because... Wait a second. There we go. I'm just gonna put my next ammo drop in it anyway. So I may as well just constantly reload it. Oh, Hexagon, what's up? That's really good. The Gungeon's carried us through most of the game so far. Eventually, we'll return the favor. I mean, we get 100 ammo here. That's pretty good. All of these little ice bombs are really helpful as well. Because they blow up into that same icy patch on the ground. Which I can reload off of. See? There's another three of them in the room. Oh, never mind. There we go. Full reload. Back to the top 800. I don't like this room. Hey, what? Okay, so you might notice there's usually a bunch of secondary spawning waves in this room. That didn't happen because I used the blank key. The blank key does... I think like 75 damage to the whole room. I can't remember the... Yeah, I found you. I can't remember the exact number. There's quite a lot of damage to the entire room. Wait a second. Gotta see if I have anything better to use on this. Not really. And it prevents future waves of spawn. I did get hit once, but it was my blank, it's fine. Hey, directional pad, you're actually a really good gun. A real good, I'm gonna go use this for a while. I'm not gonna use this ever to kill a boss or anything stupid like that. But, it's a totally serviceable weapon, and then when you finish using it, it destroys itself and gives you a random chest. Oh, he went behind a table. No, he didn't. He went behind a wall? That's just rude. I'll refill. Shit. All of my stuff's already filled. Worst problem to have. Woe is me. I have too many items. It's actually not too many items. It's too much ammo. I don't know how to do the combos here. I've heard you can. I don't know. Probably not a thing I'm ever going to bother trying. Unless one of the combos is like insta-kill boss or something like that. In which case, I'll learn it. Happily. Now, there's actually a room with the secret room right here, right? Yeah. Beautiful. The fact that you can now, every single time, find the secret room is incredible. I adore that change. And that's got to be a clear example of the developers listening to feedback, because they seem very intent on making the secret rooms obscure and unfindable. Hell, they even had an item that was like, this will show you where they are. Beautiful. Oh, okay, there's actually more going on. You know what? I'm about to lose the rest of the ammunition in this. I don't want to have it happen while I'm in a fight. Wow! What up? Haha! Yeah! I am okay with this! Gungeon Blueprint, it'll just show me all of the maps and all of the secret rooms for all of the floors. That's great. Very pleased, video game. Very pleased with this. One of the reasons I'm not so, especially in the early game, gung-ho about using the bracket key is because since the bracket key stops the spawn of secondary and tertiary waves, you end up in situations where you actually short yourself a lot of money. Space friend! Space turtle friend. Turtle or turtle in space. I'm not going to get enough money to really buy anything good next floor, so I'm just going to make sure that I have the keys. Alright, down another floor. It's all good so far. I actually probably want to revert to the Gungeon, because the Gungeon is going to be so simple to refill. Poor example. In fact, another example would be, I can actually just walk back into this room, let the forge hammer drop, and then refill off of the remains of the forge hammer. Anytime I want. So if I don't think I'm getting enough ammo from other sources, I can easily just get free ammo from that room. This room, as long as I don't tip over every brazier, I can come back at any point and just refill. Along the lines of doing this. Oh, there's 100 ammunition for me. Don't mind if I do. I've got to remember, using this specific gun on next floor is going to make me take damage. So I should try and hold off if I can. You sell stout bullets? I actually want laser sight more than stout bullets, especially because I have the spread of this weapon that's actually a little hassly. It would be hilarious if I use the bracket key to prevent the secondary and tertiary waves here. Because the whole point of this room is it's secondary and tertiary waves. But at the wow, there goes all of my blanks. Good work, Ryan. The But at the same time, I really actually want the money. Oh, that's going to be really good. It's one of the amulets I was whining about not having. All right, let's go to the forge first as well. Because if I end up with only 58 on this floor... obviously, I know where that 58 is going. Dang it. Anyhow, if I only end up with 58 on this floor, I... what? Okay, great. Now I need to try and get as much money on this floor as possible. This is exactly what I was worried about. Now that I need to get as much money as possible, I can't afford to do things like, you know, bracket key rooms. Seeing something good in that shop actually weirdly heavily limited my gameplay options. Okay. You, and then all over. You too. And also quite good. I don't want to do that room, but there's... yep, there we go. Good hit. Good hit, Ryan. Good hit, Ryan! God, I'm good at this video game. And pulse cannon's okay. I have enough room clear for the next floor. I'm gonna make the correct decision and pick up laser sight first. If I get enough money for the other one, I get enough money for the other one. If I don't get enough money for the other one, I don't get enough money for the other one. I'm fine either way. Okay. Whoop, I'll be taking that one, thank you very much. No! Anyone else? Hey, knew that guy must have been one or two hits from death. So I was kind of just waiting for Space Dude to get him. Mm-hmm, that'll do. See, I'm not gonna have blanks for the boss fight. This is what's frustrating me. This is the only point at which this really falls down for me. There's a green in a different room. Gonna have to go for that one. Sorry, bud. Oh, yeah, gonna have to waste some ammunition here. I think Turtle Friend already killed the other guy. Yeah, it did. What? This one with the revolver knot? Usually the revolver knot's one of the side pieces, not that. Oh, well. Yeah, that has a synergy with the B one, but I can't remember what it is. I think the Bs shoot twice as fast and they're twice as big or something like that. If there is a blank in the shop... ooh, there's a blank over here. That's actually really clever. Any blanks that drop on the floor while I'm clearing the floor, if I have this item, I should leave and then come back to before I complete the boss. That is a tier above the brain level I'm thinking at. I like it. I like it a lot. Alright, what do we got? Oh, big ol' bees! Okay, I really didn't think I was gonna be caught there. Which, in retrospect, is seeming quite stupid. So I'm firing slower, but the bees are bigger. So I guess this just makes this a more ammo-efficient weapon? That seems to be the case, I guess? Can't really tell you. It's just keep clearing, just keep clearing. See, that's the one attack I should never take damage on, and I did earlier. Okay. Beautiful. I think I follow up with Gungeon, right? Gungeon against the heart. It's the fastest output of damage I have. I actually definitely want the Gungeon out just for the fact that I'm going to want its speed up while I'm doing all of this dodging. Yeah. Just short of a one cycle. Thankfully, if I get hit here, I'll just blank. So I believe the master round is pretty much guaranteed to me now. So I only missed the first floor master round. That's actually quite good. Maybe this full metal jacket doesn't doom you as much in that respect as I thought. Maybe.
Maybe. Maybe.
Or maybe it's a miracle that I've gotten anything here. Okay, I've got two chests to destroy, in fact. Beautiful. Let's go destroy this one first. Yep, no, actually completely fine, thank you very much. I have to go through the room to get to... No, I'm actually gonna end up taking damage in the trap room leading into there. If I'd been smart enough to open this passage, I'd be fine, but... Since I have to go through a trap room to get back in there, I'm not doing it. I'd take damage, which would cause me to lose the blank. When I lost the blank, there's no reason to even go there. And now it's just, can I get out of this room without taking another hit of damage? To which the answer is almost invariably, no. You're very bad at this video game. Nothing else. All right. Let's check this map layout. Up, 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 up. Left. Up, 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 up. All right. Wow. God, this is a normal layout, but... sorry, an abnormal layout is what I was trying to say. Let's use the weapon that keeps us the furthest away from the enemies to start with. Pretty much any opportunity I get, I'm gonna be using the bracket key. Turn into a chicken! Chicken! Got him. See, I don't care about the money I get. I don't have anything that would make me care about the money I get, like gilded bullets or something like that. So all I need to worry about is whether or not I'm clearing all of the rooms without taking damage. Easiest way for me to make sure that I clear the rooms without taking damage is going to be preventing respawns in rooms. This room doesn't even have any respawns, plus the A key, sorry, the bracket key rather, wouldn't actually kill many of these. So I'm actually just going to clear this normally. See how many shots we're gonna have to waste here. Hey, got him. Should just be the last one up here. Yeah. We fill the beehive first. So the shot against the king there was pretty much just like a warning shot. Like, hey, stop trying to summon. Seems to have worked. Good rolls. This fellow up here, and how are you doing, friend? Oh. Does Full Metal Jacket make you immune to physical? That's actually something I should test. Because just... dang. It seems like it did, because an ankle bite hit me and I didn't take any damage. It's something I should test, but it's also something I don't really want to test right now. It's something someone should test. I'm in a position to be that someone, but also, no, you do it. Whoa, stay away. Stay away, friend. I'm not gonna blank this room yet, because what if I end up taking damage in this room? Then that'll blank this room anyway. Okay. What up, secret room? I kinda wanna keep the hexagon, to be entirely honest with you. This one can go for free. This two. This three. This four. Alright. Now we're on to only if the weapon runs out of ammunition and it has no further viability. No further spawns. Hey, it's kind of like I've killed the next wave before it even came out. I love it. All right, I need a free reload for this somewhere. I'm not gonna get any in this room, which means I'm gonna need one later. Okay. Good lord. Doesn't matter about knocking him back. Only matters about killing him. You, okay, left. This was the last thing I had to worry about. Because for the rest of the area, it's held true. You just go left or up. Whatever is the option you have. Here we had left and up as options. Okay, there's a free reload for the Gungeon. Unfortunately, it did cost me two hits to get. I don't know if that was worth it. There's another one. A key that I'm not gonna need. Alright, well, if I'm not gonna be refilling anything before the boss, I may as well throw away the weapons that I'm not going to have. Hexagon first. Alright. Rest of these weapons were essential for the boss. RIP! Rip primarily to the boss, surely. Ooh, summon some friends. Please do that attack. That's just gonna be hilarious for me. Got him. Summon some more friends. Just a bunch of time you get to spend doing effectively nothing. Okay, this is a good attack pattern. Any of the attack patterns that I can dodge without actually having to roll, those attack patterns allow me to just fight the entire time. Those are the best. I should just wait until he dies here. I don't want to waste any of my bees. The bees are going to be important. Second wave should actually be bait launcher. Whereas the final wave goes back to bees. Alright. Now that we've had a whole run with it, my ruling on Full Metal Jacket. Sight, I guess. It requires very mindful management of your resources. I don't appreciate the amount of tigers that are just, like, apparently allergic to fighting the enemy here. Taking absolutely too much damage in this fight. Alright, well, never mind. This used to be an easy win. Not so much anymore. Oh god, it is this attack. Yeah, we're fucked. Yep, we're dead. I hate that attack. So we took a bunch of damage in the second section as a result of poor rolls, but also, it's worth noting, it's important to have blanks in those sections, because when you end up in a two-hit kind of combo, where he does an attack that hits you, and then out of panic, you roll into another attack that hits you, that would be prevented by a blank. So one blank is worth two hits there, whereas in a lot of other rooms, it's only worth one hit. If we'd preserved our blanks throughout the floor by not having Full Metal Jacket, we would have been in a better position to actually deal with those. I also played relatively poorly in that fight. I rolled sideways a lot of times where I should have rolled backwards. There were a few bullshit series of attacks that I usually would just have a blank for, but you know how it goes. Ultimate ruling. I think it's mediocre. I wouldn't buy it, but I wouldn't drop it. It's way better with synergies, and without synergies, it is... Is that it? Is that it? Is it a situational item? I think it might be a situational item is what I'm looking to say here. For the moment, my name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been Enter the Gungeon. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully we will see you next time.